The event, to be played in conformity with the prevailing COVID-19 protocols, will attract close to 150 players and will be key during the Kenya week that started on December 6th. Addressing a press conference at Shitante, the Kenya Deputy Head of Mission Kennedy Mukoya said that the tournament will bring together key leaders in government, the diplomatic and the business communities, as well as other golfing clubs.
The tournament brings together key leaders in government, the diplomatic community, the business community, and other golf enthusiasts. The event is not only a celebration of Kenya's independence, it is also an appreciation of the political, economic, sports, and cultural ties of the people of East Africa.
Meanwhile, KCB Bank offered 66 million and NCBA Bank offered 10 million. Judy Nakensha, the Tusker Malt representative, said that they are so excited to be part of the Kenyan celebrations and proud to be part of the cause.
We're here to announce bigger celebrations with our neighbors, Kenya as a nation. As you've heard from previous speakers, Kenya is celebrating Jamhuri Day this weekend. There are a series of activities that the Kenya High Commission and the Kenya Fraternity in Uganda is organizing to mark this day. And one of these activities is the golf tournament that is happening this Friday, the 10th of December, here at the Uganda Golf Club. As is the tradition, we shall end the day with a prize-giving ceremony that will take place right here at the 19th hall, sponsored by Tusker Malt, and we have a lot in store for the day.
The 2019 event was won by Mark Namanya and Brenda Maraka in the men and ladies categories and will be eager to defeat their titles at the Part 72 course. Report compiled by Rachel Tibandiki for the news.